getting down to a lightweight pack makes hiking a lot more fun and a lot easier. Go ultralight backpacking with confidence and comfort to places away from city lights, to places where you are immersed in the natural world. This pack right here, fully loaded, weighs less than 10 pounds. I changed a few things from last week, and I'm continually learning and fine-tuning my kit for each adventure. See the narrative down below the video for details on the kit. In this episode, I will spend 3 days, that is 2 nights, at the Moss Lake Primitive Campsite at the Enchanted Rock State Natural Area in Texas. I'll be camping on the dark side of the rock, and so I'll be camping about 2 miles around the trail to the backside of there, to the big rock outcropping. Hopefully, if the sky stays clear, I'll be able to watch the Perseid Meteor Shower both nights. It is very hot, with a high temperature predicted to be 103 Fahrenheit, and humid, relative humidity about 49%. This translates to an unbearable heat index of 126, so it'll feel like it's 126. In addition to that, the park rangers say that there is no drinkable water on that side of the mountain, on that side of the rock. And I might be able to filter some water, but I don't know if it's good enough. If I can find water, it'll be good enough to filter. So I might be trying some innovative approaches. If I can't find water, I have a backup right here. In addition to the water that I'm carrying in my pack, this extra gallon is a little bit of a safety. Well, let's go hit the trail.
Man, this is getting steep. It goes up and up and up. Oh man. I need some shade. I need some shade. Oh. Oh. Well, it's time to get up and move on. Oh, I got a drink. This is the life. Ah, I'm hot and thirsty. John Gould, the author of the book, How to Camp Out, advice from a Civil War veteran, suggested taking water and then putting a little bit of lemon juice in it. And he said it would quench your thirst. And I know I do that today, But I just wanted to mention that, that's not new. That idea of putting a little lemon in your water started a long time ago. So I'm just going to take this lemon, cut the end of it off a little bit. A few little drops. That water's so refreshing. Save the lemon to use later. That's good. For lunch, we're going to have ready-to-eat wild salmon. It's going to be inside of a spinach wrap that has chopped tomatoes and blueberries. So this is a really special wrap. Let's see what that tastes like. It's better than I eat at home. I think I'll be coming to this spot several times during this campout, because this is a really cool area. And if it were to rain or really be uncomfortable, you just go back there and you'll be nice and dry. This is there are a number of little shelters like this. This is a good spot to set up a ground hammock. The oak trees keep it nice and shaded. It's not far from the lake. And this branch here will allow me to set my hammock right next to the ground. My ground hammock's all set up. Same type of strap that I had last time. This is just as fast as it's a Dutch strap and clip. A structural ridge line right across here. The hammock set up so that when I sit on it, I'm on the ground. And there are a couple reasons for that. One, I really prefer being on the ground if it's soft. So here I'm touching the ground, because I don't really like to rock very much. And then this is in a spot where there's a lot of leaf litter and makes it very comfortable. Another reason is that the park prefers that you don't hang hammocks because it can damage the trees. And so by doing it this way, I'm not really putting much weight on the hammock because most of my body's on the ground itself. Now I have my GoPro camera here, my battery charger, and underneath these socks is a tripod. I have two tripods this time because I'm going to try to capture the meteor shower tonight, and so I'm going to have a couple cameras going. Now, I did do a couple things to this pack. I'm still using the 28-liter Ozark pack. I like the size of it, but I had to change a couple things. Again, I had a back piece, an internal structure that I put into it last time. That worked well, but again, to reduce weight, I have a much thinner one. This is a piece of plastic that I got at Lowe's Home Improvement, and it's used for making signs. And that will be my cutting board this time. And then also, I made another improvement in the hammock, or in the pack, in that there's an internal water bladder, and it would always slip off of these little clips that they had. They aren't strong enough, and so I put some small aluminum carabiners, and that holds the water very easily. Everything else works fine. Because I've added a tripod, you know, this took a little weight, I had to sacrifice something, and I have a different pillow. I hope Bear doesn't mind, but this pillow right here is a really nice little pillow, and it weighs only a couple ounces. Sprouts right here. My lights, I have two night lights, one I'll use for photography. And then over at this side, I have my water, my extra water jug, these two water bottles, and I will be refilling water at Moss Lake. Feels really good. Yeah. Now it's a ground hammock with a mattress. Oh. Well, I hope the water filters well, you know. The ranger said it wasn't good water, but they just might be thinking people would drink it without filtering it. It looks as good as any water I've seen. And I'm going to filter this water and boil it. That's a nice view of E-Rock. That's Enchanted Rock. Looking good. I'm super hot, and I figured out why. I looked at the temperature, and it's about 118 degrees. 118 degrees, it says. No wonder I'm dying. This is so hot. Man, I gotta get back to camp and get in the shade. I'm home. There's my hammock. Nothing better than home sweet home. Looks so inviting. Bon appetit. Lemon tea, beef stroganoff with mushrooms. I've added the mushrooms. And avocado stuffed with sprouts. I'm gonna taste the avocado first. They look so good. Oh wow, look at that. Mmm, that's good. Creamy.
Sprouts are excellent. And this, the mushrooms, the mushrooms are the right addition. It makes a plain meal special. This is pointed to the North Star, and we should be able to see around it. And on the front left side will be that beautiful oak tree to help ground the night sky. Should be awesome. Almost done. Bon appetit. Blueberry lemon tea with pieces of dried apricot. It's so good and refreshing. Blueberry muffins. Here I have two. You can try this one. You'll like it. I've been nibbling on this one. Oh, wow. I can't get over how good this blueberry lemon tea is. It's just right. And the dried apricot pieces and the blueberries add a little bit of sweetness. And the sprouts, you know, they just continue growing and growing. Although I've eaten a lot of them, I have more of them now than when I started. Thank you. Oh, I'm thirsty and I'm hungry. I'm gonna go sit over here and have a snack. 89 degrees. That's quite a bit cooler than it was out there, where it was over 100 in the sun and walking around. These rocks are really, really very cooling, very refreshing. Well, I'm gonna have some sweet peppers, chicken breasts, and sprouts. I wish you could join me. You like this too. Chicken breast. Oh look, the persimmons are ripe. These are really awesome persimmons. They're really sweet. They have big seeds in them, but they're juicy and sweet. Excellent Texas persimmons. Well, it suddenly got cloudy with a lot of wind. I'm gonna go tighten down my sleep system area. I might put the tarp up now, but I hate to because it's still hot. You know, that's the fun part of camping. You never know exactly what's going to happen. The tarp I put was really fast in terms of getting it together. I know it's not very neat, guys, but this has got to do because it's thunder's now rolling in. You never know when you're out like this how quickly the storm starts. So I've got everything that I need dry under the center of the tarp. You can hear the wind's coming pretty bad now and the rain's coming down. I'm getting inside. Let's see how this works. I tightened the hammock that raised it a few inches so it's no longer resting on the ground. I took the items that I want to stay perfectly dry. I put them under the center of the tarp area so they're directly under me. And so now I'm now using this as a regular tarp, as a regular hammock. So it works very well. It's comfortable. And you can hear the raindrops. And you can see how everything's going out there. And I think this is going to be a very pleasant evening. You never know what to expect when you go camping, that's for sure. You can see the structural ridge line to the hammock is also the ridge line for the tarp. And so I'm glad I put that in. It makes it much faster than putting up a tarp like this. And this tarp is totally waterproof. I've had other storms that I've been in when this inexpensive Walmart sidewall I've used, and it is wonderful. It's not expensive at all and it works beautifully. And each side has these little elastic clips on it, and those stretch and make it very easy to put up as a tarp. I'm also glad that I brought that trekking pole. You know, you can use a trekking pole for lots of different things. You know, hiking, holding up the side of a hammock, or holding up a tarp for a hammock as I did here. Good night, guys. It's getting dark. It's pretty relaxing listening to the sound of the thunder and the raindrops. I like the way the raindrops sound when they hit the tarp. Sweet dreams. Good morning, guys. It's almost 6:30 and it stopped raining. And so it's about time to get up. Oh, this hammock was so comfortable. I slept really well. My pillow is really good. I like this pillow. Well, I just heard the first birds. So let's see. Let me open the hammock. There we go. Let's see. Oh, it's a little too dark out there for you to see, but just a minute, I'll show you what it looks like. Let me get up. Oh.
I had a great time the last couple of days. I came to experience the dark skies and a meteor shower. And not only did I get to do that, but there was a surprise rainstorm. It tested my sleep system, which stayed perfectly dry. But now it's time to go home. And so you can do the same trick that I do. Snap your fingers and everything will be cleaned up. Your campsite will all be cleaned up. The only thing you have to remember to do is to pick up the trash in the area where you're camping and on your way back to your car. Until next time, peace. Okay, here comes the trick. Wow, campsite's all clean. Water bladder is full. Thank you. It's time to hit the trails.